Fellas, I have some really unfortunate news, so please take a seat and get comfortable, because things have gotten serious from this point forward. Last week I made a video about that individual at the ice cream store that did the unthinkable to that ice cream, and we also talked about the grand marshal of this whole turn of events that has been labeled a trend and a challenge. No, it is not a trend or a challenge or a clout chase. This is a crime against humanity. And up till this point, no one had actually been affected. It was just all these crazy people doing this, recording it, and all that stuff just for clout. But yesterday, a lady went to a Walmart to buy some conditioner for her hair, and she came home. A few days later, she used the conditioner to wash her hair, and as she was leaving the shower, she noticed that clumps of her hair were just arrayed all over the shower walls. More clumps of hair were still falling out, and she looked in the mirror. She saw that patches of hair were just gone, just bald spots here and there on her scalp. What happened? Somebody mixed Nair into the particular shampoo that this poor girl bought at the Walmart. Now, when I heard this the first time, I was like, what is Nair? I'm very cultured in certain aspects of life and popular contemporary stuff, but to balance that out in other aspects, I'm just completely clueless. So I didn't know what it is, so I looked it up. So Nair is this cream that removes hair from parts of the body where you don't want hair to be. Now, for females, that would probably be your legs or your arms or other places, depending on who you are. So someone took this substance and the chemicals and then mixed it into the Pantene conditioner. And when she used it, she lost her hair. Now, let me make one thing clear. I'm pretty certain that this girl is around my age range, or at most in her 20s. People our age are very self-conscious, and hair and how it looks is a huge part in that self-consciousness. As you get older, you learn that no one really cares, and if you are, you've probably already been settled in life, so you probably shouldn't care. But at this point, it's in our nature. So something like this happening, this should not happen. She had to shave off all of her hair because it was just too brittle and it was just falling out, even up till the point on the following day where she decided to just let her hair go and shave it. It was still falling out. She couldn't get hair extensions at the doctor because her hair was too brittle and it would have added strain to the hair that she had left. So she had to shave it, and now her hair is gone. So the self-conscious levels are just way up there, because girls, guys alike, they really care about their hair, because at that age, it is a huge part of their self-expression. Some other areas, like me in New York, I'm in the Bronx, so like guys of my culture really talk about hair like 24/7. They talk about growing it out and getting all these different hairstyles and stuff. And it varies depending on where you're from. We're just going to read her Facebook post, and it's going to be up on the screen. She wrote, "As I type this, I'm crying because that's all I have done since this incident. This is raw and has hit me like no other. My hair was finally the way I loved it to be, and now it's gone. These photos I'm sharing are personal to me, but apparently needs to get out there. Most of these were from last night, through the night, and morning. Hair had fallen out and still was falling out in clumps before I shaved it. Pictures do not do justice or show the 100% damage it has caused me. My heart hurts terribly. I don't even have any words to say to anyone, as I just can't get anything out but that it hurts and it has been scary. My only intention for sharing this is to prevent it from happening to anyone else. Check your bottles wherever you get them. Nothing can be trusted anymore. Please do not bash me." If you ever have the slightest chance of bashing this girl for whatever the hell reason, you are probably an inhumane individual, just like this guy who decided to mix Nair into this conditioner at the Walmart. You know what frightens me is that people have stopped recording this. So it's not a clout chase anymore, and I said this last week in my video. It's not a clout chase. There's some ulterior motive, and this is it. Simply put, it's just to hurt people, and it's a crime against humanity. This person that licked the ice cream in Walmart last month, people saw this, it went viral, and all these crazy, mindless individuals thought, you know what, instead of a clout chase, this is a great idea to hurt people that I'm never gonna meet in my life, and just walk away. This isn't a prank. You do pranks to your friends, and they're supposed to be non-destructive. If they are destructive, then you already have a plan to compensate or reimburse them for whatever damages that you might have caused, intentionally or unintentionally. I really hope whoever did this is found as soon as possible. It is said that the police are looking over the security footage, so hopefully they can identify the exact moment where the person was seen mixing this substance into the Pantene conditioner and just left it there for someone to take home. And unfortunately, it happened to be this girl. Please, somebody tell me, what is there to gain from this? You're not recording yourselves like a moron, but there's security cameras in every corner of supermarket stores or just in the general public, so you're gonna get found either way. They can get your fingerprints on the conditioner. They can request to use it as evidence for the investigation, and they can find your fingerprints. This is 2019. This isn't the 1700s where if someone got murdered, the murderer or the suspect could just move to Siberia or something and never get found again. Change his name and all that stuff. No, this is 2019. We have modern technology and we have cameras. You will be found. You will be brought to justice. And not only that, you're ruining the reputation of Walmart and you're ruining the liberties that we take for granted every day. I guarantee you that in a few years from now, if this continues, or even if this doesn't continue, this is just more than enough to instigate extra precautions that will take certain freedoms that we had and just bring them down, down, and down. Walmart and other stores are just going to put security cameras in every corner. They're going to start locking up these things that either have skin application or their consumables, etc. They're just gonna get locked up. So you know how it's convenient for you to just take it off the shelf and look at the back and see if it has anything that you need that is necessary for you before you buy it? No, you have to call the employee from all the way across the store with the keys to come unlock it and do that. And if it doesn't have what you need, then you're shit out of luck. They're gonna have to plastic wrap all of these items now, because quite frankly, that is one of the most simplest and straightforward ways to see if something has been tampered with. You know, if the seal is broken, you just don't buy it. But in these cases, we don't know. The only way that she knew was when she saw that there was something wrong with her hair. And she and her mother, I believe, took a look at the shampoo and it was an ugly pink color, as they said it to be. Pantene is supposed to be white, not an ugly pink color. I just have a word of advice for all of you. Just buy your stuff from Amazon or from other e-commerce websites, online stores, or whatever, because I highly doubt that the warehouse workers are going to take the time out of their day, risk losing their job, just to sabotage some sort of item that is going to be purchased for absolutely nothing. Trust me. Like I said last week, if you still want to go to a retail store, just get stuff from the back of the shelf, because that is less likely to be tampered with. But honestly, just buy stuff online, because I would rather wait a few days for something to come in the mail than to buy something from the store that is 20 minutes away and then have my life ruined, get sick, or what have you. The girl and her family started a GoFundMe to cover the cost for a new wig to replace her hair, medical costs, as well as legal costs. So I link that in the description below in case you're feeling generous and you want to support their cause. They're about a third of the way into their goal, so you guys are free to donate if you have anything to spare. I honestly don't know what direction that humanity is going in. There are certain times where people redeem themselves and give me and other people faith in humanity, and then people like this, horrible people like this, just absolutely ruin it. And we go like 5 steps back for the 1 step forward that we made. Like, what has gotten into people's minds? You just don't go into a store and sabotage stuff like this for some sick joke with the intention of hurting people long term that you don't even know. You're telling me that people can't even buy stuff from the store anymore without having to check twice? Well, I hope this ends soon and that hopefully one day, maybe a few months from now, we can look back at this and say, wow, people actually used to do this. Whatever it takes, man, whatever it takes. mistakes. Listen, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Leave a like on the video, not for me, but with the hopes that one day all this can just stop and we can put this whole thing to rest for good. I'm going to start a Minecraft Let's Play because I promised I would bring Minecraft back with some 1.14 action. Stay tuned for that by subscribing and turning on post notifications. Comment whatever you want, whether it be positive or negative. I'll catch you guys later in the very next video. Stay awesome.